YouTube, how's it going? And welcome back to AJ's Garage. Thank you guys for tuning in. And today's video is not truck specific, but actually carburetor specific. So this will be the first time that both trucks are in one video. So being carburetor specific, we're gonna be installing an electric choke on the 74 dually, which has the 390 in it. So I'm working on simplifying that engine, getting everything really reliable for possibly swapping it into my 70 pickup. But starting off with the 70, they both have two barrels again, Motorcraft. And with this one, it has a heat activated choke. I'm not sure specifically what this one is, but it has a tube here, which allows, I believe, exhaust gas to come up and works with the coil that's in there. Now, part of the system has been removed. That little pinched off line, I believe, went up to something else that pertained to the system. I'm not sure what it would be called. Maybe some of you guys can let me know in the comments. And also recently, I just actually hooked this one up. Starting the truck and driving it, the idle was always all over the place. Sometimes it would fast idle at the beginning, kind of at a decent speed, and then kick it down once it warmed up. But sometimes it would kick up really, really high where I would have to kick it down immediately so that the RPMs didn't shoot up too high. So I recently found a diagram on this one where I was able to make this wire here. So we just got a connector. I did also adjust this because the line here was way over to the left. So I just lined it up, which is pretty much a straight up, I guess, generic setting that you can have. But making this wire, wired it up here, used some heat shrink tubing, and on this style choke, it has it hook up to the alternator to a certain terminal that's under there. I'll include the name of it, I can't remember off the top of my head, but I've started it up a few times since I've done that, and it idles pretty well at startup. It kicks up a little bit, truck warms up, and then you're able to kick it down. So that one we're not going to mess with, we're going to leave that alone. And what we're going to be working on is this one. So when I picked up the truck, this is the choke that it had. So it doesn't have any terminals. I believe it's another heat activated choke where you would have a heater hose kind of come through here and it would tee off from one of these lines for the heater core. So I've seen them at the junkyard where it just tees off and it runs through here, and that's how the choke would be activated, I guess. So we're going to be removing that and installing an electric choke. So I'd seen and heard about this on another video. I'm not sure if some of you guys might follow Auto Resto Mod, but I happened to find this on his channel, and this is from Mike's Carburetor Parts, and he went over the reason why he prefers this kit, which is mainly this little terminal here, which acts as getting a temperature reading inside the engine bay, so it'll leave the fast idle on a little longer than it normally would without it. So this will keep the choke on longer, I guess you could say, which would allow the truck to warm up correctly and then run a little smoother once you get going. So we're gonna install this. I'm gonna go over installing it and wiring the power source also. Now, of course, your truck probably could have three different style chokes, either a manual choke, which you would adjust with the knob in the cab, an electric choke, or a heat activated choke, which both of my trucks currently have. So let's get started. We'll install this one and I'll go over that. So getting started with the installation, first you have to remove, obviously, the current choke that's on there. So I know that certain style chokes have a little bit of a different retaining system, whereas both my trucks and both carburetors have this style ring, whereas others have kind of these end pieces that just secure each mounting location. So this one will have this ring, of course, we're gonna reuse that. Store this aside for now. We won't use it, but we'll hold on to it just in case. So this kit also comes with two of these red plugs. Now, what these do is they'll block off this back vacuum location, which would let hot air into the air cleaner. So that one I've already had blocked off. And then we have this bigger cap, which will block off the heat riser from the back here, which is what my other truck uses. Now, of course, this intake manifold doesn't have a provision for that. So that one is missing. Actually, I removed it. So I believe what it had was a line that went over the valve cover and then hooked up down to the exhaust manifold. I did see that in some pictures as well. So I think that's what this had. So we'll just use this cap and plug that off. And then we'll pop this off. So the kit comes with the new gasket. So this one, of course, isn't in bad shape, but we're gonna use the new one. At first, it seems like it's a little too big, but once we get the cap on there, it'll be fine. So now this is the spring that adjusts the choke and opens it up. So you do need to get that to line up with the cap here on the inside. So what we'll do is line those up, and then of course this is the indicator to match up here to the top again. So that's just the generic setting. From there you can adjust it for your needs. So we'll make sure that that goes in, and then we'll line it up there at the top. So now we just got to get this back on, and it obviously goes on a certain way, so you just kind of have to line everything up there. So now that the cap is on, going over the connections, starting off with the ground, that one goes up here at the thermostat housing. Per the instructions on the kit, this is where it wants it to be located. So all I did was remove the bolt, use some sandpaper to clean up the thermostat housing just a little bit to make sure it makes a good solid contact, and then put that back on. Again, this is a sensor, so it'll pick up heat probably a little more accurately and quicker on this coolant passage where the thermostat is. So that's where it asked it to be located. So I just ran my wire, it goes up there to the cap. And then as far as the positive and the power, I ran that up across the firewall, through the firewall there where the speedometer cable goes. And that one I just hooked up to power. Now it wants it hooked up to power with the key on. You don't want constant power so that when you turn the truck off, it's still drawing power from your battery, which would kill your battery. So I hooked that one up, just used this same kind of little terminal. I had some extras, so I just crimped that onto the connection. And that one I hooked up to the little fuse box down by the emergency brake. There's little extra tabs on there. I know those are there because I used those on my 70 F250 when I used the power from that to get power to the aftermarket gauges and then power to the USB power plug that I installed. So got power from there, ground up here on the thermostat, and that's it. That's how you install this specific electric choke. I'll include the part number for this from Mike's Carburetor Parts. Of course, depending on where you are and the weather, you would adjust it left or right depending on your specific situation, but with mine I just left it straight up, and that wraps this one up.